Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And this video we are going to talk about the diseases of bone. So without further ado, let's get started. And welcome back to another 5 in 5 series where we cover each topic under 5 headings in 5 minutes. And today's topic is the cleidocranial dysplasia. As we know that dysplasia means abnormal growth. Cleidocranial, that means we will be talking about the clavicle. So there is going to be the absence, complete absence or hypoplasia of either one or both of the clavicle. And there is going to be abnormal growth of the skull. So that means we will be talking about the frontonails and the sutures. There are open frontonails and there is because of delayed closing of the suture of the skull which happens, as well as there is failure of the tooth eruption. So this is about the cleidocranial dysplasia in general. And before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future videos. Talking about the cleidocranial dysplasia, that means abnormal growth of the clavicle and the skulls. This is a rare genetic disorder which is characterized by abnormal growth of the bones in the clavicle and the skull and the face, and it has a tendency for the failure of tooth eruption. So the tooth, some of the tooth, they fail to erupt. So there is going to be prolonged retention of the primary teeth and there is going to be failure of the eruption of permanent teeth. So there are delayed eruption of the permanent teeth, and also we see there is lack of cellular cementum in the permanent teeth. Also we see the multiple unerupted supernumerary teeth in the mandibular region, in the incisor and the premolar region. So in the cleidocranial dysplasia, there may be complete absence or there is hypoplasia of one or more clavicles. And what happens, these people with the cleidocranial dysplasia, because clavicle is not there. Clavicle bone, you know that our clavicle bone, right? So if collarbone is not there, then what happens? These people, they can approximate their shoulders forward until they meet in the midline, so they can make their shoulders meet in the midline. So this is what they can do. There is going to be hypermobility of the shoulder joint, and this is the reason that these people can move their opposing shoulder medially. They can get it close up to the midline. So this is because there is either the partial or there is complete absence of the clavicle at all, and there is weakness of the muscle which is attached to them. So this cleidocranial dysplasia people, they can approximate their shoulders. So there is going to be a bossing which is present, and which is because of the frontal and parietal skull plates. They are elongated. Because of that, there is bossing which is present, and because there is prominent frontal and the prominent parietal bone, we know that there is a deformity or abnormal growth of the skull. So there is big huge frontal and the parietal bone, and because of that the person's head look like the Arnold head. So the patient has got a big huge head, and because the frontal and the parietal bone are very prominent, so the head is like this, like broad. So that is why, like this head. So that is why the Arnold head. And because there is an abnormality in the skull, so there is delayed closing of the suture. So there is a big head, frontal bossing, delayed closing of the suture. When there is a delayed closing of the suture, and this is the reason that in the radiograph also we see that. The skull, there are open sutures, there are open frontonails which are present. The suturous line is very tortuous. In the skull, they are very curvy suture line, and we call it the Warman bones, with the open frontonails and the open sutures are present. See, also we see the oral features are, there is prolonged retention of the primary teeth, and where there is delayed eruption of the permanent teeth. We know that these permanent teeth have got lack of acellular cementum, and there is high arched palate, there is underdeveloped maxilla we see, and we see unerupted supernumerary teeth in the mandibular incisor and the mandibular premolar region. So in the radiograph, we are going to see that either there is going to be complete absence or the partial absence of the clavicles. And also we see that the tortuous suture lines in the skull bone, which we call the Warman bones, with the open frontonails and the open sutures. So there are multiple unerupted impacted teeth which are present. They can, mostly they are some of which are the deciduous teeth, right? So the roots of the teeth are very thin and they lack the acellular cementum. This is what we see, that there is a lack of acellular cementum depositions. So this is about the cleidocranial dysplasia. You have to remember it, cleidocranial. So clavicle is not there. There is abnormal growth of the skull and there is failure of eruption of the teeth. So because of that, the patient can approximate their shoulder. There is shoulders. There is hypermobility of the shoulder joint. So this is about cleidocranial dysplasia. If you have enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Also, you can comment in the comment section below. And there is a link in the description box below to support me on Paytm as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and free notes. So till then, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated, and I'll see you soon in the next video.